Oregon. 84971, you're free to go.
She was sorry she couldn't make it. She had to go to work. Get in.
Yeah!
So how was it?
Ah, it was beautiful, Dennis.
I'm thinking about going back next year. Whose car is this?
Oh, and I got you a job if you want one. Same place as me.
No, I'm good, man. I got plans.
What plans?
Venezuela. I met this guy inside, and he's telling me all about this oil rig, so I figured, you know, I'd get myself a passport, a little cash, and a ticket out of here. All I need is a start.
Oh, yeah?
Where do you get starts from? Is it yours, Leo, the car? Stolen.
Yeah! You picked me up in a fucking stolen car, Leo, Dennis? Are you kidding me?
I feel a little bit of a crash in my dash coming on.
What are you doing, Leo? Stop the car!
Hey!
Don't be such a dink.
Are you kidding me, Leo? I just got out of fucking jail.
6 months for ripping off a few cars. Big deal.
Ever. Ever do that to me again, you hear me?
It ain't like it used to be, honey.
It never was.
Smoke a joint.
Let's go, Dennis. Justice.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, justice. What is it? And what is it worth? In a libel case like this, we have to put a value on it. Though, of course, it's not just about money. And never has been. There's a speech I remember being made to learn by heart at school. Time to find a new assistant.
Oh, you're sure that's the quotation?
He left it on your chair.
Not what you tell Mr. Crane.
It's Shakespeare. Who steals my purse, steals trash. 'Tis something, nothing. 'Twas mine, 'tis his, and has been slaved to thousands. But he that steals my good name robs me of that which not enriches him and makes me poor indeed.
He's the senior partner in the firm, which means after me, he's the most important person you'll meet. Remember the way, you'll be doing this a lot when he's got a gig on.
I saw him on the news last night talking about the Russell case.
Should end today. Crane hasn't got a hope. All Selena's going to be getting is his bill.
Selena Russell was bankrupt in every sense after that newspaper article appeared. It finished her career. And as you've heard, she can't get on a plane. She can't go into a restaurant without people thinking. No, believing that she's nothing better than a common prostitute. Is that justice? No. It's a human crime. And for what was this crime committed?
A tabloid newspaper article, 22nd read on the nation's toilet. Is that justice? My client's reputation is her career. And her career is her life. And her life is in ruins. I ask you a final time. Is that justice? Well, if not, you tell me, how much is it worth? Where's that little shit of Miles? His ass is fired.
Sorry, Mr. Crane. Gotta be honest with you. She lost it.
You're a fortunate man, Miles. I remembered it. Just.
How in the hell do you win this one?
Got lucky with the weather.
Here's your fan mail, sweetheart. I gotta get back to work.
Only two?
Well, one of them's a parking ticket.
Thanks, Aunt Maddie.
Yeah, thanks, Mom. It was great.
What's that?
My birth certificate.
What do you want that for?
I told you, Mom. I'm getting my passport.
You're not serious about that oil rig thing.
Yeah, you tell him. It's a stupid idea.
Hey, you can still rip off cars during the weekend.
Nathan. Give it to me. I'll get your passport for you.
Nope. You lost the last one. Let's go.
It's a good thing you had time to clean up, huh? Hey. What's up?
Ma?
Nathan.
Ma, please don't lie to me anymore.
I mean Martin. When I was pregnant with you.
Told me. I mean, I wasted my whole life listening to you.
It was your mother's decision.
My whole life. You've been telling me what to do.
I adopted you. I gave you everything you wanted.
Criticizing me? Preaching to me?
You ungrateful.
You never loved me. But you know what? You're not my father. And I'm glad. You know, I never felt like I belonged here with him. But I might have a family somewhere.
Your family is here.
Half of it.
His name is Callum Crane. He was a law student.
Does he know about me?
I never told him.
Why not?
He was very ambitious. He wouldn't have wanted to be held back by us.
Yeah, but maybe if you told him, things would have been different.
Not necessarily better. He's not the answer to your problems, Nathan. He won't want to know you.
Better.
Fashion model Serena Russell left the city courtroom this afternoon considerably richer than when she went in. $2 million is one of the largest libel settlements ever awarded this kind of case, and is a personal victory against all the odds for Callum Crane, one of the country's leading criminal defense attorneys. And in other news tonight, a fire broke out down...
All right, that's the last bottle. I have to get up next week.
Will they appeal?
I would if I were them. In fact, I may even suggest it.
One day, Callum, your genius for getting the guilty off and winning undeserving lowlives vast sums of money will be punished, I hope.
I bet I make federal judge before you.
You're a devious, amoral hypocrite.
Exactly.
Give Natalie my love. She prefers diamonds. How is she?
Who knows? She's asleep when I leave and asleep when I get back. For all I know, she never gets up. See you tomorrow.
Drive carelessly.
Scared me.
Sorry. What are you doing here?
Having a great night out with my friends. Mr. Crane, what are you doing here? It's my first day and Miles said he was breaking me in.
Leave it. And I'll give you a ride home.
Are you sure, Mr. Crane?
You can call me, sir.
What do you want to drink?
I'm buying.
Drink.
Whiskey sour. Double.
So what about you? You don't want to be one of our secretaries your whole life.
I don't want to be one of your secretaries at all.
So what do you want?
An easy job, which pays very well. Absolutely no skill or education required.
Such as?
Miles's. Oh, I think I'm well overqualified. Are you married?
I'm really not sure. Are you?
What do you think?
I never think unless I'm paid.
Are you trying to get me drunk, Mr. Crane, sir?
No.
Why not?
Sit down.
I'd rather watch you fall over. I thought the idea was to get me drunk.
I know. What are you trying to do? Take advantage of me?
I haven't decided yet. I think the milk is bad.
No.
is a terrible idea.
Why?
You are married, you're drunk, you're my boss, you take your pick.
You want to?
Don't. Not anymore. No.
Shut up!
How dare you speak to Faith like that? She's practicing.
Why isn't she at school?
Why aren't you at work?
I'm not going in for a while. Taking a vacation.
Oh, we'll all be glad to help you pack. What is wrong with you, Callum? Anyone would have thought you'd lost that case. Sometimes, Sophie.
I'm thinking about getting another job.
It took you months to get that one. You can still go to the police.
I don't want to talk about it.
Do you want me to do something then? Tell me his name and I'll report him.
I keep going over how it happened. I let him on time. I'm so stupid.
You said no, and no means no. Don't let that bastard get away with it.
Your ex-husband's here. What does he want?
Damn, he's early.
Faith, Amy, Daddy's here.
We're coming.
Let him in, would you, Callum? And don't mention work.
No, why not?
He got fired this week, along with half the agency.
Giles?
Hello?
So, how's work?
Natalie didn't tell you?
No. What?
Daddy!
Hey!
Daddy! It's
so good to see you.
Yeah. Can we go for ice cream?
So, how's my little princess?
Let's go swimming. No, actually.
Oh, Callum, someone called Miles phoned. He said you have to go to the office immediately.
Let's stay up real late.
Dad! That's
why.
Dad.
What else did he say?
Faye!
So, what's this urgent problem I had to come in for?
You've got a meeting with the CEO of Trans-Pacific, starting three quarters of an hour ago.
Where is he?
On the conference room ceiling.
Thank you, Miles.
About the other night.
I'll take the stairs.
I'm a little unhappy, Miles. You know, the efficiency in the office, the atmosphere, would you say that it's all it used to be? No.
No.
I was wondering, and that new secretary?
Sophie.
What do you think?
Difficult to say.
I'm not so sure either. Obviously, it's completely your decision.
You think maybe she's,
Well, like I said, it's completely up to you.
I thought maybe you and she were,
No. No.
Right.
Just wanted to get your opinion.
Fired?
Yep. Yeah. You're still on your trial period. No warning necessary.
Why? What did I do?
Call in next week to pick up your paycheck. And clear your desk.
What do you want?
What do I want? Harassed, propositioned, raped, and fired in my first week? What more could I possibly want?
Exactly what I've given you. Fresh start.
You know how bad I could make things for you?
How? You don't have a chance of proving anything. Since the other night, you've been let go, so any fuss you make now is going to look like cheap revenge. Plus, you're getting a month's pay, which is very generous.
If I were your lawyer, I'd really have to advise against taking any action. I'm glad we could talk.
No, hold on, he just came in.
Those cars doing outside?
You've totally forgotten, haven't you?
Forgotten what?
Most of them are your friends.
Oh, God. Who's this?
The Department of Justice. You've been a naughty boy, Callum.
Hello.
What has two thumbs, is French, and loves a blowjob? Moi! Callum, are you all right?
No. I'm a federal judge.
Oh. A judge? Yeah. You made federal judge? I don't believe it.
Neither do I.
Somebody down there likes me.
To you.
Ever look at the sky and think there must be something up there controlling our destiny?
No.
Neither do I.
So, what happens now?
I finish this bottle and fall over. And next week I get sworn in and start controlling other people's destinies.
It's a funny life. It's all happened so quickly. One minute you're a drunk earning millions of dollars a year lying to judges, and the next minute you're the judge.
Not exactly how I would have put it. The amazing thing is I've actually gotten away with it.
Gotten away with what?
Oh, everything.
I'm going into the city. I'm gonna try to find my dad.
That won't take long.
Yeah, I got his work address, you know, so it's a start. Listen, tell my mom I'm like sick or something.
You are.
By the way, I borrowed Leo's car.
Oh, that is nice of him.
Well, I was hoping you could break it to him, you know, sort of gently.
Nathan!
Tell Leo we're looking for him.
Tanya?
She's not picking up.
Yeah, well, we're gonna be late for the open house.
Hey, Ton. Can you do me a favor and pick up my paycheck for me at the law office?
Sure. When?
They're expecting you.
Okay, well, where are you going?
To see a man about a job.
What job?
His.
Excuse me. Yeah, hi. I'm looking for
I'm looking for Mr. Crane.
Mr. Crane doesn't work here anymore.
Oh. Well, can I get his home address of where he lives?
He's a federal judge, for Christ's sake. I'm not giving anyone his address. Yes?
Look, sir, this is really important.
So is this. A paycheck for who? Sophie Lennon? Yes, send her to accounting. Look, if it's that urgent, he'll be in tomorrow evening. You can come back then.
To call the police.
Oh, no. I don't want to bother the cops. I mean, unless you do.
But your car.
Oh, don't worry about it. It's a wreck. I'm not going to claim.
You mean it?
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I'll give you a ride.
Yeah?
Yeah, wherever you were going.
All right. I was, I actually headed down to Mexico.
Excuse me?
Yeah, it's the first day of my vacation. I was driving down to Mexico.
Oh, no. What have I done?
Is that true?
Complete lie. I was going for a drink. It's been a long day.
Okay, but I'm buying.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Callum?
Well done.
Yes. Hey. Choice be yourself.
Judge!
Well done, Callum. Glad to have you with us.
Good, I've been doing nicer first.
So this horse walks into a bar and the bartender says, what's with the long face?
I'm sorry you got stuck with this one, sweetheart. Shall I take over?
I hope you can stand the drop in income.
I'm sending the children out to work.
That'll be the strippogram.
That would be typical bad taste, like all of your jokes.
What's wrong?
Terrible.
They're kind of growing you, though.
How is everything?
Yeah, fine. You?
You know, ever since our little chat, I assumed there was nothing I could do. You being a lawyer, and paid a fortune for twisting the truth. Like you said, it was your word against mine. While you were a lawyer. Then it occurred to me, now you're a judge, I don't have to prove anything. All I have to do is make an accusation, and you're finished.
Take some free legal advice. Be very careful how you handle this. Do you have any idea what you'll have to go through? And do you really want to do that to yourself?
No. But I will. Unless you resign. I'm not vindictive. You can go back to lying for a living for all I care. But the thought of you being a judge on a rape case or something.
Sophie, you're upset, and that's entirely understandable. But I know this system, and I've seen what it can do to people. And believe me, the only real way to get over this painful misunderstanding is to let it go. Otherwise, it will take over your whole life. And I just can't see the point of that.
Can you?
Look, I know it's difficult being out of work. If there's anything more that I can give you...
I didn't come here to bargain with you. You raped me. And if I haven't read by the end of the week that you've resigned, I'm going to the police and the papers. see myself out.
So I got 12 months for first offense, that's 6 for good behavior.
That must have been just awful in court.
It was. It was. I mean, I saw my whole life flash in front of me, and I wasn't done in it. What do you want? Bikini? I don't think I want another father that doesn't want to know. I didn't expect him to be so different.
What do you mean?
Well, the offices and... I don't know. He's from a completely different world. And besides, I don't even know if I'm the sort of son that I'd want. Here.
Sophie! This is Nathan. I destroyed his car tonight.
Cut him into tons. What the hell is that?
I bumped into him when I picked up your paycheck.
And?
Okay, I like him. So if you keep your hands off.
I'll force myself.
He's come here to look for his dad, so I said that he could stay for a little while.
Where?
On the coach. Unless I get lucky.
Oh, Jesus, Tom, you gotta be kidding me.
Oh, he's the sweetest guy. He wouldn't hurt a fly.
No!
This is our apartment. You don't tell me who can stay and who can't.
So, there you are. Where did you disappear to last night?
I was worried.
It's funny. You want something so much. Your whole life. You think about it, you plan for it, and then when you get it, it's like when you were a kid. Opening a big present and finding something really disappointing inside.
It didn't happen in my family.
I think what I was trying to say was, it doesn't feel right being a judge.
What are you talking about?
How would you feel if I resigned?
Are you serious? Why? And do what? You can't practice as a lawyer again. You've accepted a federal judgeship.
Well, I don't know. I'll think of something.
You'll think of something? I think you've finally lost your mind. You want to give up everything we've worked for, and for what? To do something you'll think of? Jesus!
Wallet. very impressive back there.
Yeah, well, it takes practice.
So you often assault people in parking garages?
No.
And what did I do to deserve your help?
Nothing. Nothing at all, actually.
What do you do?
It varies, I guess.
Okay. You're clear here. This is where you're getting out. You don't like the police, do you? Why? When'd you get out?
What?
Prison.
You ask a lot of questions, don't you?
Just one more. You want to make a lot of money?
Hey.
Hey. How'd it go? Did you see him?
Well, what's he like? What does he do? What happened?
You know what? I didn't really tell him about me yet.
Why not?
I don't know, it didn't seem right, you know? But I'm seeing again on Thursday. Yeah, he told me something about a job.
A job?
Yeah, I figured, you know, you do it well, and it's a perfect time to tell him, you know? Again, it's a good side sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, it was weird. You know, I'm sitting there, I'm staring at him, and I'm thinking, I mean, this is my dad, right? But he just didn't feel like he was.
Well, turn my back for 2 minutes.
Nathan, this is Connor. Connor works with me.
Oh, hey, listen, is it okay if I stick around till Thursday?
Yeah.
Cheer up.
There's only enough for two. Get it?
Don't move. Wow. I want to remember you like this always.
Uh-huh. I've just been for an interview.
What happened?
I burst into tears.
Tears? Is that good? I mean, because I haven't been on too many interviews myself. Listen, why don't you let me buy you dinner?
Sorry. Tanya's arranged for Connor to cook me dinner or something.
Well, where? I mean, there's no one up in the apartment. I've been trying to get in for an hour.
Really?
Yeah.
Maybe he's called it off.
Dinner, then?
So, are you and Tanya...
No. No, no, no.
Are you gonna be?
Why do you ask?
Like I said, I'm nosy.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know. I'm not much of a judge of women.
You sound like someone who's had his heart broken.
sleeps in my rooms mostly. You know, modern women, they're very physical. How long have you known Tanya for?
Since seventh grade. She's the best person I've ever met. You have no idea how lucky you are that she likes you.
It's a good thing they called me reservations, huh?
That is so incredibly selfish.
I'm sorry, this is my fault. I shouldn't have,
I'm tired. See you in the morning.
Oh, you are so busted.
Yeah, I guess I should get back onto the hallway before someone else bags it.
Well, you've been promoted to sofa.
Hello.
Sophie, please.
It's for you.
Who is it?
Who is this? Just tell her it's urgent. Hey, he says it's urgent.
Hello?
Sophie, it's Callum Crane.
Properly the other night.
It caught me off guard, I'm afraid. I didn't react well.
Fuck you.
I thought you were meeting your dad.
I am. Tonight. Do I look good? You think?
Yeah, you'll do. So where's Sophie?
Look, Tan, about last night, nothing...
Why do you like her? I'm just curious. Why do men find her so attractive?
I can't... I don't...
Just be careful tonight, Nathan. Sometimes people can turn out to be a really big disappointment.
Something I want to say.
Say it later. For now, I want you to listen. I got a problem. I'm successful. I have money, reputation, large house, a good family. But I got a problem. And the problem is blackmail. A woman with whom I had a brief sexual association is taking advantage of my position, and I can no longer meet her demands. In spite of my attempts to reason with her, she's threatening to destroy my career and my family by revealing it all to the press.
Why can't you go to the police?
Because that's no guarantee of keeping the story quiet, and because destroying somebody's life isn't necessarily illegal. It's not a solution. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, I don't.
The woman disappeared, so would the problem.
Why are you telling me this?
Because I believe you can help me.
Why me?
Because I think you need the money. I think you're capable. and you have absolutely no connection whatsoever with me, the woman, or the problem. I got one day left before she carries out her threat. In the envelope is a photograph along with her name and address. $5,000 in untraceable cash with a guarantee for another 25 afterwards. If you don't want it, I'm sure you know somebody out there who does.
You're gonna trust me this? I could spend this and never see you again.
I don't have any alternative. If you don't help me, I'm dead. It's as simple as that. That's it.
Open the envelope, Nathan.
You don't believe him, do you?
Of course I do. He's a judge.
Blood's thicker than water.
He wants someone killed, Nathan.
I know.
But so why did he take the envelope, then? You going to do it, then?
Nope.
Just to take the money and run.
Listen, you trust me, okay? I mean, you'd never see me again. You wouldn't even know I existed.
Let's do it. Shut up, Leo.
I'm in a world of shit. 30 grand to get me out. If we don't do it, someone else will.
Well, come on, you just got out of the slammer 10 minutes ago. You know, cars are one thing,
yeah,
but
maybe it'd be good, you know, this woman, you know, to do justice.
Oh, we don't know that.
Look, he's my dad, okay? I can't do nothing.
Open the envelope, Nathan.
Oh, fuck, shut up.
Look, we're not going to the police, and we're not going to warn the woman because we don't know what happened. Do nothing, say nothing.
I say open it. Don't worry about your conscience. I'll do it. You'd never even know. Besides, make up for my car. Come on, thank you too much.
Deal,
huh? Huh?
You're the fucking up.
Fuck around.
Come on.
Relax. Whoa, Dave. Hey. What are you doing? I don't want it, Leo. That's money, man. It's the way out. No! No! You... God! I don't want it. I don't want it. You fucking idiot!
And next up at KWX Morning Classic, news and rush hour traffic. All after the weather with Mitch Grigson.
A little cool outside, Brenda, today. We've got winds coming out of the southwest by 15 miles per hour. This afternoon is going to clear up. And we are going to have sunny weather, about 65, 70 degrees today, but the clouds are going to come back in tonight. And we may see some precipitation.
No jobs?
I'm looking for resignations, not jobs.
What?
Hello? No one. Ton, I have something to tell you.
Deadline.
Yesterday, the day before, it doesn't matter. He won't resign. He's called my bluff, bastard. And I don't think I can go through with it.
Sophie, I don't think that you want my advice. I think you just want me to tell you that you did the right thing.
Go on, then.
Sophie. You did the right thing.
Probably giving the guy a hell of a scare. Worst week of his life.
Still less than he deserves.
I bet he didn't believe I'd do it anyway. At least I don't have to go through any more shit.
What's this for?
Now I know there's something wrong. When have you ever needed a reason to drink?
It's probably my turn to apologize. I've been very tense recently, and I know I've been difficult to live with.
What was it?
A situation at work, which I handled very badly.
What situation?
It doesn't matter anymore. The problem's gone away, and so has my solution for it.
I just don't understand you sometimes. I should go. Therapy.
Couldn't you miss the shrink for once?
It's boring, I know, but it's very good for our marriage. I think he's having an affair.
I don't.
Well, a breakdown, then. Something's just not right.
You must have been looking for us everywhere.
This Sophie is so gorgeous and smart and funny. What I don't get is what she sees in you.
You know what? I don't know if she sees anything in me. That's why I'm going back. Find out.
It's like you got this weird compulsion to getting your heart broken. You know what you should try sometimes? Going for a woman who is actually interested in you.
And what makes you such a great expert on romance?
Well, the one advantage of women never wanting to go out with you, you can stay very objective. I can see things you can't.
Yeah?
Yep.
All right, here's Sophie's number in case you gotta get a hold of me. And I guess this is it.
Take care of yourself, Nathan.
Yeah.
Be good.
You too.
$5,000 isn't enough.
Betty, you can get the rest tomorrow. Today, I'm doing a job. Big job. Betty, please. Please.
Shh. Did I lose over you? But it's true, oh, it's true. Sing along, Leo.
Benny, I swear.
Sing it.
Darling, what can I do?
Louder, Leo.
And I don't know, honey. And I don't know if I please understand.
Sing it!
Crying over you. Crying over you, and over Benny, when I'm crying.
Last chance. Don't disappoint me.
Okay.
sing song with Benny. Thankfully, he's not killing me till tomorrow.
Did you give him the $5,000? You're not gonna do it. Leo!
I'm dead if I don't, Dennis. What do I care about some bitch?
Huh? Think about it. She's a bitch.
Come on, Leo.
No! I need this money.
Gets home in about half an hour.
I'd like to wait for her inside.
Tough.
Just got back. I'm about 10 minutes away. I'm near some bus stop.
Listen, can I come over?
I'm sorry. I'm tired.
It's been a long day. Dennis called.
Sophie?
He said it was an emergency. He wants you to call him.
Sophie, wait, listen.
You're close by.
Could you please drop off the front door keys through the mailbox? Oh, Christ. Nathan, I gotta go.
Sophie. Hey. Sophie. Fuck.
Excuse me, ma'am. I'm still waiting out here for Mrs. Gilbert. And I was wondering, are you sure?
You couldn't just let me in to wait, please?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Ma'am, I'm still waiting.
There's a bar on the next block. Why don't you wait there?
Yeah, I know that, but I want to come in now.
Leo found the envelope, the money, the photo.
Nathan, he's gonna do it.
Nathan, do you hear me?
What am I supposed to do about it? Huh?
Sophie doesn't want to see me again. I got 10 bucks in my pocket. I got no place to stay. And frankly, I don't give a shit.
Well, you would if it was your Sophie getting smoked.
What do you mean, my Sophie?
All I'm saying is you should look at it like that.
What are you talking about, Sophie?
The woman's name is Sophie, that's all.
Sophie what?
There, you see?
Dennis, come on.
Lennon, same as John.
Dennis.
Yeah, and Yoko.
Are you making this up?
No, I'm not. I mean that's what this...
That's the name.
Come on.
Hello?
I don't believe I've got you.
Hi, Mom.
You know him, huh? Callum Crane, you know.
What?
Just tell me the truth. Okay, Sophie, just tell me the truth.
What's it to you?
You screwed him, didn't you? Huh? You screwed him and you wanted money.
Who told you that?
Yes, it would be
always. Don't touch!
Just tell me the truth, please. Jared. Tell me it isn't true, okay? Just tell me something! I'm sorry, it's not safe for you. Gotta open the door, please. Open the fucking door, Sophie. Sophie, I'm sorry. Sophie, listen, I'm gonna be outside, okay? Don't open the door for anybody else, all right? Sophie, please, come on.
Your sister, of course she can stay. Why do you sound so surprised?
You refer to her as the Antichrist, Callum, and I personally heard you telling her it's lucky to fly in thunderstorms.
Excuse me, I'm in a good mood.
Yay!
Whoa!
Did Faith tell you she got into drama school?
So, my check passed the audition, huh?
Yeah!
Oh!
I'm expecting friends.
You finally bought some, that's nice.
Let's go get some candy.
See the news this morning?
I wasn't in it, was I?
No.
Well, then.
You remember that secretary we had recently, the difficult one that Miles fired?
How has she done?
Nothing. She was battered to death in her apartment last night.
My God, that's terrible.
Do they know who did it?
The cops? Are you kidding? They need a diagram to put spaghetti on a plate. They're appealing to witnesses, any possible leads. In other words, everywhere.
Shouting and screaming. And he kept hammering on the door, but she wouldn't let him in. I wouldn't have either.
Have you seen him before?
I first saw him about a week ago, maybe. He started sleeping out in the corridor there. I didn't like to say anything. Like I said, he looked kind of rough.
Do you know his name?
Nathan. Nathan Corrigan. He's been sniffing around Sophie for a while now, but she never wanted anything to do with him. It doesn't surprise me what he's done. It doesn't surprise me at all.
Wait up.
Open it up.
Wait up.
Come on.
I'm coming.
Come on. Now!
Where is he? Huh?
What the fuck is he, Dennis?
Huh? No.
Now! Tell me!
I don't know.
I don't know!
Now! You tell him. I want the rest of my money. Or his dad's name. I don't care which. You understand?
Keep doing this.
You think I don't know that? Huh?
Why don't you tell Leo where Crane is and let him get on with it?
Because Leo ain't getting a fucking thing for killing Sophie. That's why.
Fine, all right. What do we do about this?
I got her killed, man.
It wasn't deliberate. That's between Leo and Crane.
Doesn't matter.
Will you forget all that? There's no shit you're not in right now. You hand yourself in and they'll nail you. You don't and they'll find you. You can't give up your dad or Leo without giving yourself up too. And even if you try it, they're both gonna finger you anyway.
Give me a drag. So what do you think, huh? What do you think I'll get for telling the truth?
15 years for conspiracy to murder, probably.
I don't even know why she was killed.
What does that matter now?
That's the only thing that matters now.
Hello.
That's me.
I didn't think anything was gonna happen. I need some time.
Tonight.
I don't have all the money.
I said tonight at the docks, 12 o'clock.
Why'd you want her killed?
We shouldn't be meeting. Your face is all over the news.
How inconvenient for you.
Okay.
You don't look happy. Why aren't you happy?
You got caught.
Yeah, I was, and I didn't even do it. Why'd you want her killed, huh? I mean, is anything you told me true?
Take the money and get out of the country.
I want the truth.
It doesn't matter.
It does to me.
Yeah, she wanted to tear my life apart. You think I did this for fun?
I want to know everything. Tell me everything.
You're in trouble. Take the money.
Oh, you're? You see, now I prefer we. It's much more comforting, all that togetherness.
There's nothing between us. That was the whole point. Goodbye.
Yeah, and if you weren't my father, well, then you'd get away home free.
What?
May 1975. Sonics make it to the playoffs for the first time ever, and you get laid by a high school senior named Madeline Tanner. One night, here I am, here we are. And that's what I wanted to say to you, but I got scared.
Thank you.
need your help.
Tanya. Wait. Listen to me. I didn't do it. Tanya. It wasn't me, Tanya. Listen to me. I didn't do it.
Hey. Give me one good reason why I should trust you.
There aren't any.
Celebrate.
Right. Anything in particular?
I'm a father.
I suppose when you think about it, it's surprising it doesn't happen more often. I mean, the number of times that people stumble into bed with complete strangers and never see them again. Especially you.
The time you never recognize those tiny, tiny moments which change your life so completely. But it makes you appreciate other things. Natalie. And how little time there is for everything. And you, I suppose. Thanks for listening, Brent. We'll bore somebody else now.
What is this place?
It's a rental property. They don't move into tomorrow afternoon. We'll be safe tonight. Why don't you go to the police?
My friend saw her at the apartment. Don, I got a record.
For stealing cars?
I told you. I don't trust them.
Oh, so you don't trust them, but I have to trust you. Is that it? I'm scared, Nathan. I miss you so much. You didn't deserve this.
Never would have worked between you. Anyway, your timing was off. She'd just broken up with someone. And she was getting over that and lost her job. And before that.
What?
Before that, she was...
Tanya?
She was raped. I don't know his name. Someone from the office, a lawyer. She was ashamed. She didn't think that she could prove it, so she didn't want to go to the police. But that won't help poor Sophie now. You're not telling me the whole truth, are you?
But what happened?
I know that you didn't kill Sophie. But you're not telling me everything. I don't want to see you again until you do.
Didn't you?
Huh?
What's it to you?
Tell me!
I figured out what happened. It's a little late for that now, isn't it?
Why'd you want her dead,
huh?
She didn't report you!
She told me she would.
Aren't you sorry?
Alex, I'm sorry. You can't do it, can you?
But you don't think I won't,
huh? You think I won't, huh?
You think I care anymore? Goodbye.
From now on, you'll do everything that I say. Now, I've addressed this envelope to the DA's office, and we'll send this tape unless you find me a place to hide the passport and way out of the country. Got until tomorrow. Who actually killed her?
What does that matter? This guy, Leo, used to be a friend of mine.
Well, it's all yours.
Doesn't it bother you at all?
Look, I feel as bad about it as you do.
This is not worth it anymore. I can't see where it's going.
It's not going anywhere. It's an affair, not a bus.
For God's sake, Brent. He really needs me at the moment. I don't know why. Of course, you never do with him, but he does.
Therapy.
Exhausting.
Maybe I should introduce myself. I'm Nathan's father. Who's Leo?
I want to know where Nathan is.
He's safe. And if you want him to stay that way, you'll tell me where I can find Leo.
Last time I heard, he was looking for you.
Then help him out. I'll be at the Queen's Hotel.
It won't be easy. He's had to disappear, you know. These real heavy people are after him.
I'm sure you can get him the message. $5,000. He told me you two had an arrangement.
No! 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 He did not!
I'll kill him. I will.
I don't think he understands about business. Maybe you should just talk to him yourself.
You know where he is?
The only one that wants you dead, Leo. Who is he? The guy that told me to wait here for you. I'd be interested to know. Well, you should have chosen your friends more carefully.
Scared the shit out of me.
Come on.
Where are we going?
You took the tape. I want it back.
We'll get into that later.
No. Now.
I'm not giving you a choice. Running away is never an option. All you can do now is trust me.
You gotta be kidding me.
Say nothing. I'm gonna need 48 hours.
Say nothing to who? What are you talking about?
Across the bridge to the plaza. When a phone rings, answer it.
Megan, this is the police. Place your hands behind your head.
Callum, what are these doing here?
They're yours.
Well, I know they're mine, but what are they doing down here?
I was hoping you'd fill them with your things and take them away, along with your children. If your mother can't fit you in tonight, please find a hotel and I'll reimburse your expenses as part of the settlement.
What are you talking about? What settlement?
The divorce settlement. Or will you be staying with Brent? It would be cheaper. I'd appreciate it if you'd be gone by the time I get back.
You get a confession yet?
You won't need one, sir. We've got enough forensics and circumstantial to nail him dead.
Keep at him. I'll call the DA. We'll charge him in the morning.
Phone call, detective. Apparently it's urgent. Caller says he can identify the real killer, sir. He says it wasn't Corrigan.
I know it sounds strange. It all started with the photo that Nathan brought back of Sophie. The moment Leo saw it, he was just obsessed. He couldn't stop talking about her, saying he was gonna meet this girl, and that she was too good for Nathan, and that how romantic and perfect it was gonna be when he met her for the first time. He was totally unreal about the whole thing. I don't know, personally, I think he was going really weird. He had had a lot of trouble and he's pretty heavy around.
Go back. You're losing the story. Go back to the beginning. Come on, you have to know this. They're gonna go over it and over it and over it. So let's start again from the beginning. Why didn't you tell us all this before?
When I found the stuff, the gun and the photo, and I realized what he had done, I was scared. I mean, I was really scared. You didn't know him, he would have killed me. And anyway, he was a friend since high school. Didn't seem right. But then when I heard he was dead, didn't seem to matter anymore.
Leo Kilpatrick, on bail for possession, GTA, assault. I won't bother you with the psychiatric evaluations. They're taller than my son. Forensics say the killer was almost certainly Kilpatrick, not Corrigan. Blood under the victim's nails was Kilpatrick's, plus fingerprints on the gun and photo, which Corrigan doesn't have, plus positive ID of Kilpatrick's motorcycle outside the house on the night.
Hmm. What did Tacoma PD say about the explosion?
Gang killing, drug related, they weren't surprised.
Very convenient for Corrigan. It's all too neat.
Yeah, well, the people who could tell us what really happened are all dead. Shall we get an extension or let him go?
Corrigan.
I know.
Hey. How you doing, man?
Good.
Sorry.
We'll go home now.
Actually, Maya, I gotta go talk to someone first.
Is that it? I could have you sent away, you know. You, Dennis Green, all of you. Suppose you just expect me to forgive you.
You know, I don't know if I forgive myself.
Why tell me now?
You said you wouldn't see me again unless I told you the truth.
So what am I supposed to say? Don't worry about it. It could happen to anyone. Let's go get a pizza. It doesn't happen like that.
You know what? I'm sorry. I shouldn't have come. I'm sorry.
Nathan? Maybe you should give me your phone number. You know, in case I want to call you later and yell at you some more.
There are few crimes more heinous than that of rape. And you've shown little or no remorse for the distress that you've caused an innocent woman. I hope that 10 years in prison will give you time to change your mind. Take him away.
Message 1.
It's me. I don't know why I wanted to call, really. I guess to say goodbye. And to ask you a question. How you ever be able to live with yourself?
1 a.m. Monday. Message 2.
I sentence you to life.
Hi, it's me. I followed your instructions. I'm at my mother's. Maybe we can talk. Anyway, there's food in the fridge and habit, I suppose, but I mailed that letter on your desk. Went to the DA's office.